Hi and welcome to Roo's Kitchen and Garden. Today I'm going to make a chicken preparation which is a Malwani chicken or it's called a sagoti. This can be eaten with vada or you can also eat it with normal chapati. So this is called vada komda. It's a Malwani speciality. For the vada we are going to use an instant dough or an instant atta flour today. But I will surely someday show you how to make the vadas at home. And this is really a delicacy. My mouth is watering while I'm describing it. And on a rainy day, which is like a perfect weather for anything actually. But it's a perfect weather for vada komda. So let's go and see how to make the komda or the chicken or the sagoti for, it's not the shakoti, it's different. Let's see how to make the chicken curry for to go along with the vadas. Yeah, so let's see the ingredients. To begin with, we need 4 onions, small to medium size here, out of which 1 onion is going to be chopped fine, and 3 onions you're going to chop thinly, you're going to thinly slice them. Then we need turmeric, we need salt, red chili powder, then we need some ginger and garlic paste. This is around 2 inches of ginger and 5 cloves of garlic, 5 to 6 cloves of garlic. Then we need 3 inch piece of cinnamon stick, and we need 1 teaspoon of coriander seeds, dhania. Then we need half teaspoon of shajira, which is caraway seeds. We need 1 teaspoon of black pepper or kali miri, like they call. Then we need a little piece of mace, and we need 4 to 5 dry red chilies here. We also need khaskhas, poppy seeds, and we need 2 teaspoons of Malwani masala. Now this is my homemade Malwani masala. I always make it at home and I keep it. How to make it at home? It's a long process. There are a lot of ingredients that are required for this, but I will surely make a video on this. For now, I make this and I freeze it. So it stays fresh and remains like this in the freezer for a year or two. So out of which I have taken 2 teaspoons. Sorry. If you, as you know, if you don't have the time to make it, or if you can't make it, or if you don't want to make it for some reason, you can buy it from the store, from any, not any specialty Indian grocer. This is called Malwani masala. Alright. We also have some freshly grated coconut. This is 1.5 cup of freshly grated coconut, and the main ingredient, which is the chicken. I have 1 kg of whole chicken cut into pieces, skin removed. To this I am going to add ginger garlic paste, salt and turmeric. So here I'm going to apply some turmeric paste. First let me put salt. This is just enough for marination. Later we'll taste and add some more in the curry. So as you've seen, 2 teaspoons of turmeric powder I've used, and all of this ginger garlic paste I'm gonna use. Okay, and let's mix it up nicely and leave it to marinate for around 30 minutes. Now take a pan, and when it's hot, add some cooking oil to it. Whichever cooking oil you add, and we are going to roast the dry spices. So we are going to roast the dhania seeds first in the pan so that it imparts nice flavor to the oil. Then we are going to add the pepper. Then we'll add our mace. Now mace is very important in Malwani cooking. There is a peculiar taste that mace imparts to the curry, so do not skip the mace. The shajira, the khaskhas, the cinnamon, and the coconut, and the onion, the thinly sliced onion. So I will let this first roast nicely, then I will add the onion, and then I will add the coconut. So this is roasting. Let me show you what vada atta I am using. So Again, vada atta is a long procedure. So if you don't want to do that, this is the one I'm using. I get this in Singapore. Bhagirathi, it's called. Vada flour. There is a shop called Sushadi. They specialize mostly in Maharashtrian products. They source it from Pune, Mumbai and places like that. So that's a good store. I found this there. They always have this. So you can use this. It's an instant vada cake. You can use any brand. I get this in Singapore and hence I use this one. Now the spices are nice and hot, roasted, the aroma is coming out. So I'm going to add my onion, thinly sliced onion. And then I'll add my coconut because coconut cooks fast and starts burning faster. So let me give this a nice mix and let me soften the onions. So much so that they turn brown. Okay. Now the onion color slightly changed as you can see. So I'm going to add the coconut into this. Grated fresh coconut. Or fresh grated coconut. And then give it a nice mix. And keep stirring this till both become nice and brown. So you see the color, it's nicely fried now. And this is how it should be. It should cook very well and become brown. Because this actually is to be added in the end. So cooking this is really important because it completely changes the taste. So you need patience while you're cooking this. Onions and coconut should nicely saute and turn brown and then you can grind it. So take your time and really cook this well. In other cases, normally what we do is we just roughly cook and we add it again in the pan. Once we grind it, we again add the masala sometimes in the pan and then we cook it more. But this will be added once the chicken is kind of cooked. So you need to cook this paste really well because this is actually the only thing that will impart good taste to your curry. So do take time and cook this well. Now I've transferred the brown onions and the coconut into this mixer grinder and I am going to add some water and blend it or grind it into a fine paste. Okay. Add water, around half a cup. Half to 3/4 cup of water I've added. Now I'm going to grind it and I don't want to disturb you with the sound, so we'll meet after I've ground the paste. Now we finished grinding our brown paste and it looks like this. This is the consistency. Very fine. I spilled it. Very fine consistency. And we keep this brown paste aside now. Let's move on to the chicken. It's been marinating for half an hour with ginger, garlic and turmeric. So now again, I put this pan on the gas. I'm going to add some oil for cooking. Say like 1 to 2 tablespoons. Then I'm going to add this finely chopped onion into the oil. Mix it well. Fry it nicely. And till it becomes light in color. Okay. So I'll have to increase. Yes. So we serve the komda, vada komda, or this chicken and the mixed millet fried bread. That's how I can explain what this vada means. So we eat this along with something called a sol kadhi. Sol kadhi is made up of kokum or Garcinia indica, it's called. You can find this again, dried ones in any Indian stores or Mustafa if you're in Singapore, or in India it's easily available. Again, I buy it from India and I store it in the fridge in the chiller section for year, 2 year, 3 year, it doesn't get spoiled. Of course, it doesn't last in my house that long, but it doesn't spoil. And this is used for fish curries and everything. You must have seen it in my videos previously. So now I'm going to also make sol kadhi. So how to prepare the sole curry, I'll also teach you when the chicken is boiling. So yeah, now as you can see, the onion is nicely sizzling. We'll add some red chili powder. This is for color. So you can use a Kashmiri or a Bedgi, anyone which gives you a nice color. Okay? And after you mix the chili powder, you add the Malwani masala, the 2 teaspoons that we kept. If you can tolerate a lot of spice, then you can add 3 teaspoons if you want, or 4 teaspoons. Depends on your tolerance to spice. But I'm just adding 2 teaspoons because that's how much the people in my house can tolerate. So we'll also add our Malwani masala to this. So you get color and flavor in this onion. Yeah. Now, one more important tip or thing. First of all, of course, it's important for this recipe, but generally also, it's important to when you add the chicken, you cover it before you add water. Chicken or meat, anything. You don't immediately add chicken and add water because you're diluting the flavors that way. When you cover, when you add chicken and then you cover and let it give out its own water, the dish gets tastier. So always follow this. Now I let the onion soften some more and then I'm going to add this chicken and then cover it. Now I'm going to add my chicken. From everywhere, like I always do. Make sure every part touches the bottom of the pan. So first you always do this to the meat. Make sure all the parts touch the bottom of the pan. All the masalas get coated nicely. Lovely. And then you cover the pan and let the chicken release its own water. So I'm going to cover this and let the chicken release its own water. As you can see, it started to leave water. Let me give you a nice close-up. Its own juices, right? Now at this stage, we are going to add hot water. And remember, we have to add only hot water. So I'm going to add like around, say, enough to cook the chicken, so like 1/2 to 1 cup. Yeah, and I will give it a nice mix. So give it, stir it nicely, mix it around so it doesn't stick, and lower the gas flame or the heat. And cook it till the chicken softens a bit. Yeah, so I'm going to reduce the gas, cover and cook it. Cover it once again. Now let's move on to making our sole curry. A lot of people make sole curry in different ways. I make in a very simple way. I soak this kokum in a bowl full of hot water, and I will soak it along with 3 to 4 cloves of garlic. Let me bring this a little closer. Yeah, and I'll add roasted cumin powder to it. So let me add some cumin powder also. You can even add roasted cumin and crush it freshly. My cumin powder is also freshly ground and freshly roasted and ground. So this is it. So I'm going to add some cumin powder to this, and I'm going to soak this for 1/2 hour in hot water. So say around 1 cup of hot water. Yeah, and then cover and keep it for half an hour. As you can see, our chicken is kind of semi-cooked. It started to boil and it's been boiling actually for 5 to 7 minutes now, and it's got a nice red color to it. And I can see, because you know, in if you're outside India, the chicken actually really cooks very fast. The meat is very tender. Of course, if you're in India, I have noticed that the chicken takes a little bit more time to cook. So here the chicken has started to cook really well. At this stage, I am going to add my paste. The paste, remember, the brown paste that we had made. So let's add that paste to this. And we'll also check the salt, but I had rinsed my, old habits die hard, I had rinsed my mixie jar. It's a little down, let me just show you. So I had rinsed my mixie jar, and I'm going to add that water also to this. Yeah, and I'm going to give it a nice mix. I'm going to taste for salt and adjust the consistency and adjust the salt, sorry, in the curry. First, let's mix it nicely. There you go. Give it a nice mix. Sorry. Now let's taste for the salt. Now remember one thing, my chicken was little cooked, that's why I can freely taste the curry. Yeah? Very nice and spicy. It now, if you have to adjust the spice level a bit, you have to adjust the salt. So I'm going to add a little more salt for the spice to bring it a little down. Nice. So now I'm going to let this boil and keep chopped coriander ready. So let this boil away nicely. So now I had kept this chicken leg on top, so I can see whether it stops leaving blood. When it stops leaving blood, you can understand that the chicken curry is cooked. So it's nice and cooked now, smelling really nice. Now we are going to add some coriander leaf. And let's move on to our soul curry. We can, after coriander, we add coriander leaf, we can maybe leave it open for 2-3 minutes. Let the curry get the flavor of coriander leaves also. And let's move on to the sol curry. So this has been soaking for half an hour. I will give it a little squeeze so all the flavors come out in this water. I'll even squeeze the garlic. So it imparts nice flavor to this water. Now we are going to filter this water. I'll just wash my hands and show you. Let's move this away and filter this. So I've got this sieve here. This is my way of doing it. It's an easy way of doing it. Hope you like this. Take out all of it here. Again, in this also squeeze out everything. All the flavors should come out. Squeeze out all the flavors from it. Now you can add fresh coconut milk, like grated coconut, just squeeze out all the water. You use fresh coconut and then squeeze out all the cream, all the milk, sorry, from the coconut. And you should do that 2-3 times. So you get nice coconut, fresh made coconut milk. Or if you're like me and you believe in quick fix, so here I have 1 cup of coconut milk. This is store-bought Tetra Pak coconut milk. Now, if you think this coconut milk is very thick and very fatty and you don't like the taste, you can dilute it with water. So you can use half cup coconut milk and half cup water, or you can use the trim coconut milk. So now here I have my jug, and let me just change the camera angle. So here we have our jug in which we want to serve our kokum sol curry. So the liquid that we strained out, let's add it to this pan. Let's add it to this jug. Nice. And then let's add this coconut milk to it. I will need a spoon. You can even dilute it. You can even add some ice to it. Yeah, so here you go. Let's just stir it nicely. And then add fresh coriander leaf to it. Then I'm going to add fresh coriander leaf to it. That's it. It's done. So now I'm going to add salt to it because we did not. So let's add some salt and add some freshly ground black pepper to it. Nice. I've also added some ice cube, so it's cool, even cooler. And let's give it a nice mix again. So when you add some coconut milk, if you have not diluted the coconut milk, it's obviously going to tear in the sol curry. So you have to do half and half, like half water and half coconut milk. Or if you've not done that, don't need to panic. Just add a lot of ice and your sol curry, if it's tone or if it's curdled. Tone, I'm using a very exact Marathi translation, tone. Curdled is the right word. If your sol curry you think has curdled after the addition of coconut milk, which should not happen if the coconut milk is thin, but if it suppose has happened, add ice to it and it will be fine. So that's it. Our chicken curry, our chicken komadi vada or chicken sagoti, and our sol curry is ready. Once the vadas are fried and I have set a plate, I will show you how it all looks. So this is my plate with the vadas, the chicken shakuti, the sol curry and some salad. So this is vada komda. Hope you liked today's recipe and hope you're going to try and make it. If you liked it, please don't forget to like, share and subscribe. And yeah, keep supporting Roo's Kitchen and Garden. Thank you. Bye.